What's up, everybody? This is Anthony from Texas Blues Alley. It's Free Lesson Friday, and today we're going to look at something very specific. And I apologize for the name of this lesson, but I couldn't help myself. We are literally going to give Scuttlebutt in the finger, this finger to be exact. And we're going to use that to unlock something in that primary lick that leads off the song, something that I didn't notice until today, actually. And the reason I noticed it is because you may or may not have seen the video I announced or the video earlier this week that I posted, where I started a new YouTube channel for a hobby of mine, where I'm taking old concert footage, I'm cleaning it up, upscaling it to 4K using some new state-of-the-art tools. And I just so happen to be working on the Live in Japan concert. I'll put a link to this in the description of this video. But the first song in that concert is the song Scuttlebutt. And whenever I'm working on a new concert, every bootleg is different. They each have a different noise profile based on what camera was used, how many times it's been compressed, whatever. And so I usually focus on the first song and I try and perfect the process with that, because then I know I can repeat that for the other one. So as a result of working on this show, I was watching this video of Scuttlebutt a lot. And one of the things that I do in my process is I convert it from 30 frames a second to 60 using something called optical flow analysis. And basically what that means for you is that in really fast sequences, you get a little bit more detail as he moves his fingers quickly. And one of the things I look at is whether I'm getting a lot of blur in the picking sequences, like right here. And so I've spent an inordinate amount of time over the past week staring at his hands while he's doing this, experimenting with different denoising settings and sharpening and everything like that. And after I watched it for like the 100th time or 200th time, whatever, I was like, something is different about his picking than how I play it. If you remember, I taught a lesson years ago on how to play this lick. And one of the things that I called out is that my struggle was always going back and forth between the B and the E string. And when I saw this, I was like, I wonder if there's more to this picking than I have realized. And I'll be the first to admit, it has not been my goal to be the most accurate Stevie Ray Vaughan style guitar player for many years. I gave that up almost as soon as I started putting lessons on YouTube, because all of a sudden I could see people all over the world who could do this better than I could. But I am still intrigued by how he's able to play the stuff that he does, and if there's something he's doing that I can incorporate in my own playing, I want to do it. So basically, when I saw that, I decided, what better way to do kind of a deep dive on this newly enhanced footage than to use the tools I've already built and imported into our own pro player that my locals use to study video. So once I got the video imported into our pro player, I used our custom loop functionality to isolate one particular sequence where I really felt like I could see the fingers doing something that I hadn't noticed before, and I'll just play that back here at full speed. But what I want to show you is what happens when we slow this down to 25% speed and then use the video zoom. Actually, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go in and I'm going to put in a loop just around the beginning of that segment right there. There. So I've created a custom loop just for that one part. And so here is just that one short segment. You can clearly see the middle finger pluck the string right there. Let's watch it again. If you watch really closely, you can see him pick on the slide and on the B string, and then the middle finger come back and pluck on the high E string. So what I'm going to do now is I'm just basically going to show you that lick again, and I'm going to show you how your middle finger factors into playing this. So let's review the notes of the lick again, in case you've never watched that previous lesson. And I'll put some tablature up for my members when they're watching this in the pro player. We start with a slide up the G string, then pick down, and I'll show you the old way first, and follow through B string to E string. tricky part was always coming back down here to the B string. Because if you tried to do it with picking, you'd have to do a little outside, inside, or whatever they call it with alternate picking. And then we'd slide up here to the fifth fret of the B string, high E string again, third fret of the B string, open, and then either slide down to the second fret or start at the second, slide up and back, open, and then low E string, and then the chords come in. What I want to show you today is why I was struggling so much with that, and what I picked up from that video is that instead of picking this top string, you pluck it with your middle finger. So this is kind of what we saw in the video. Picking one, picking two, pluck. So you can see the finger come back, and then the pick go down right after that. And I think that's the only time he uses his fingers to pluck a string during that. But you can see this is much less efficient than... Now what you'll run into is that if you've never conditioned your right hand, like we do a lot of work on our fretting hand with spider exercises and whatever to condition it, but unless you're done finger picking, like your right hand is no different. Like you need to exercise that to get used to it. I can already feel fatigue just trying to do that. So trying, you may actually go backwards at first if you're used to doing it with all. Like I had worked on that so much, I could almost play it at full speed using just picking strokes. But it never felt like I was really on top of what was happening, and this allows me to get a much cleaner snap on that high E string. So that's going to be an exercise you're going to have to do to get your kind of middle finger and hand muscles. See, I'm using my hand here as kind of a rest. You're going to probably sometimes get too much of the string under your finger. See, I'm already struggling with it here because this today is literally the first time that I've started incorporating my fingers into picking any notes of this lick. So anyway, like I said, I will put up some tablature for my members to go along with this lesson. But there you have it. Somebody emailed me years ago and they said, have you ever looked at how Stevie Ray Vaughan used his fingers in conjunction with his pick in the middle of playing his licks? And I had to admit I hadn't, because when I was learning from him, I learned primarily by listening, so there's no picking context there. But I also learned from watching videos, and I was so consumed with picking up what he was doing with his fretting hand that trying to study picking small picking details like that on a VHS tape or a DVD was almost impossible. So if I had the tools now, the ones that I built for my members, to study back then, maybe I would have picked it up sooner. But anyway, that's the kind of stuff that fascinates me. Check out the Vintage Blues in 4K YouTube channel. I'm going to be uploading the rest of the songs from the Live in Japan concert over the next week or two. Subscribe, hit the bell. Of course, I hardly ever do this, and I probably should do it more. Subscribe to this channel too. And click the bell, I guess, that way you get notified or whatever. I don't know. In any case, I hope you enjoyed the lesson. Thanks for watching.